corresponding elements. Right, next one. Three coins are tossed together. Three coins are tossed together. Three coins are tossed together. What is the probability? What is the probability to get? What is the probability to get exactly two heads? Exactly two heads. Probability that at least two and at least one head and one tail. And one head. Not at least one head and one tail. Three coins are tossed. What is the probability that exactly two heads, at least two, one head and one tail? One head, at least one head and one tail. At least one head and one tail. Then here also our intention is the representation. What is the sample space and what is the event? What is the event and sample space? Here the sample space equal to three they are crossing, means head, head, head. Right? Head, head, head. Head, head, tail. Simply represent like your binary, like your digital electronics has three. 0 as the head and 1 as the tail. Then what are the combinations with 3 digits? 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. Okay, but it is this h is equal to head and 1 is equal to tail. You have HHT, HTH, HTT, THH, THD, TTH, TTT. These are the corresponding possibilities, 8 possibilities. Means you are having two binary. Now, digital you can link up to the binary. Binary nothing but either 0 or 1. Either 0 or 1. How many combinations can be formed? Can be formed with 2? With the 3 digits, with the 3 bits. Simply 2 to the power n. 2 to the power 3, which is equal to 8. Suppose we are adding 4 coins, then how many? 2 to the power 4, which is equal to 16. Suppose 5 coins, then total number of outcomes is equal to, total number of outcomes is equal to 2 to the power 5, 32. 2 to the power 5, 32. Here the total number of outcomes is equal to how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Since 2 to the power n. Since 2 to the power n, which is our sample space, and in that they are asking the event is equal to exactly 2 heads. Exactly 2. First event is equal to exactly 2 heads. Exactly 2 heads is equal to this one, HHT. HHD, HTH, THH, exactly two heads, THH. How many possibilities are there? Only three. Only three. Similarly, second one is that at least two. Second one is that at least two. Here is equal to only three. And second one is that at least two. At least two is nothing but two or three. Two heads are three heads. Then at that situation, you are eligible to consider three heads also. HHD, HHH also. And last one is that at least one head and at least one head and one tail. There should be one head and one tail. Though this is not to be considered here. This case is not to be considered and this case also is not to be considered, since at least one head and one tail they are asking. Okay. Minimum one head and one tail. So these two are not to be considered and total combination is equal to 6 here. Now the corresponding probability here is equal to simply, you already were having the event and the sample space. Directly you can write the probability is equal to 3 by 8 here. N of elements equal to 3 by 8 here. Which is equal to 4 by 8 here. And here is equal to 6 by 8. 6 by 8. Intention is to get the events. If you are in position to get the events, directly you can write the probability. Directly you can write the probability. Then next one. When two dice are thrown, the probability of getting sum of 10 are doublet. Probability of getting sum of 10 are doublet. Two dice are thrown. Sum of 10 are doublet. Two dice are thrown, directly write this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First of all, you need sum of 10. R is nothing but simply, if you consider this as the A, this as B. R, you are having either R, either sum of 10 or a doublet. Means you need to consider P of A union B. Already we have seen, okay, P of A union B. This one you have to calculate P of A union B. That is equal to simply n of A union B divided by sample space. N of A union B divided by n of S. Divided by n of s obviously you know because of 2 days throw simultaneously n of s is equal to definitely 6 square is equal to 36, which is equal to 36, and you need to calculate the number of elements of this A union B. Now can't say A is the event that sum to be appear as a 10. With 1 it is not possible, with 2 it is not possible, with 3 also not possible, with 4 it may possible, which is equal to 4 comma 6, which is 4 comma 6, and with 5 also it is possible, which is 5 comma 5. 4 comma 6, 5 comma 5 it is possible with 5. 4 comma 6 is possible, 5 comma 5 is possible, and here is 6 comma 4 is possible. 6 comma 4 is possible. Is there any possibility to get the sum is equal to 10? Is there any possibility to get a sum is equal to 10? 4 comma 6, 5 comma 5 and 6 comma 4. No, no. So the corresponding total number of elements here is equal to 3. And what about this doublet? Doublet is nothing but 1 comma 1. 1 comma 1. Here is possible. 2 comma 2 is possible. 3 comma 3 is possible. 4 comma 4 is possible. 5 comma 5 is possible. And 6 comma 6 is possible. Total how many? 6 comma 6 is also possible. And the n of A and B equal to simply n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. N of A intersection B is equal to this one. This appears in this one, and in this one also, this appears as a common element, this 5 comma 5. So you need to subtract that element, which is equal to 4 plus 6 minus 1 divided by 36, which is equal to 9 upon 36, which is equal to 1 upon 4. Here n of elements equal to 3, sorry, 3, not 4. 3 plus 6 minus 1, which is equal to 8 upon 36. So this is equal to whatever, 4 2s and 4 9, which is equal to 2 upon 9. Here 3 only, because they are having only 3 elements for the event A. Write down a question. A coin is tossed if head turns off. Dice is thrown. If tail turns up, coin is tossed again. Probability of getting one. Two tails. Two. Getting a head and even number. Here the sample space is that a coin is tossed if head turns up. So the sample is given head comma 1, head comma 2, head comma 3, head 4, head 5 and head 6. If tail comes up, coin is tossed again. Coin tossed again means the possibilities are only head and tail. This is your corresponding sample space. And that event is that, the property of the first question. For the first question, the corresponding event is equal to 2 tails, which is equal to TT. And for the second one, the corresponding event is equal to head and even number. Head is equal to H2, comma, H4, comma, H6. Okay, already if you formed the sample space and the events, the probability gap, writing the probability is not a matter. The corresponding probability is equal to simply n of E1 divided by n of S, which is equal to simply 1 divided by how many of this one? 6 plus 2, 8. Or 6 plus 2, 8. So this is equal to 1 by 8. And this one is equal to n of E2 divided by n of S, which is equal to simply your 3 upon 8. Okay, the importance is that understanding the question and writing the sample space. Now, a leap year is selected at random. Second one, leap year is selected at random. Leap year is selected at random. What is the chance that it contains? What is the chance or what is the probability that it contains 53 Sundays? It contains 53 Sundays. What is the chance that it contains 53 Sundays? Okay, listen here. 53 Sundays. Already we know for the leap year, already we have seen how many days are there? 366 days, which is equal to 52 into 7. 52 into 7 plus 1. 52 into 7 plus 2. 52 into 7 plus 2. For the leap year, they are asking for the leap year, how many 53 Sundays are there? Of leap year having the 366 days. Out of the 366 days, we are having 52 weeks plus 2 days. 52 weeks means definitely we may have the 52 Sundays here. Okay, 52 Sundays here. And one for the possibility of one more Sunday. We are having one more 2 days. 2 days means how many possibilities are there for these 2 days? How many possibilities are there for 2 days for the sample space? Is equal to either Sunday, Monday, either Sunday or Monday, or either how many what are the possibilities are there? 2 days. Either Sunday, Monday, Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, Friday, Saturday, and Saturday, Sunday. And Saturday, Sunday. These are the corresponding possibilities. For the 2 days, the corresponding possibilities are maybe Sunday, Monday, maybe Monday, Tuesday, maybe Tuesday, Wednesday, maybe Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, and Saturday, Sunday. How many events are there totally? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How many events are there? Our event is that should be a Sunday. That should be a Sunday. Sunday is nothing but either Sunday, Monday, either Sunday, Monday, or Sunday, Saturday. Or Saturday, Sunday. Saturday, Sunday. This is the corresponding event. How many events are there? 2 events are there. The required probability is equal to simply P of E is equal to N of E divided by N of S. N of E divided by N of S. Here N of E is equal to 2 and N of S is equal to 7. This is equal to 2 by 7. Suppose they ask the non-leap year. Suppose they give a non-leap year. Then how many days are there? 365 days. That is nothing but 52 into 7 weeks plus 1 day. Plus 1 day. This sample space is equal to this 1 day may be Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Friday and Saturday, and that our event is equal to Sunday only. Event is equal to Sunday only means you are looking for the probability or chance of coming up the 52 Sundays, sorry 53 Sundays. So the corresponding probability P of E is equal to here, it's equal to simply 1 divided by 7 here, 2 divided by 7 because of there are 2 events are there, so maybe Sunday, Monday or Saturday, Sunday, that means the 2 days are maybe Sunday, Monday or Saturday, Sunday. So the corresponding probability is equal to 2 by 7. In the non-leap year, we are having only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are the events in the sample space and elements in the sample space, and the elements in the event is equal to only one element, which is equal to S only. From this, the corresponding probability is equal to simply your one N of E divided by N of S, which is equal to your 1 by 7, which is equal to 1 by 7. Now, consider a bag contains, for every question, what is sample space and what is the corresponding event? That's it. A bag contains 8 red, 6 white, 4 black. 8 red, 6 white, 4 black balls. 4 black. Now, a ball is drawn at random. A ball, that is one ball, is drawn at random. What is the probability that ball is red, second one is that ball is white, third one is that red or white, and fourth one is that not a black. How many balls actually? 8 red balls, 6 white balls and 4 black balls. And that you are asked to draw a one ball. So sample space contains how many elements? Total 8 plus 4, 16. sorry, 8 plus 6, 14 plus 4, 18. Sample cells you having 18 elements. On that you need to draw one ball. We need to draw one ball. For the first one, so definitely denominator should be 8C1 only. Definitely denominator should be 8C1 only. And the first one is that the ball should be a red. The ball should be a red. The corresponding event of this one is equal to only this you have to consider. Only red balls you need to consider. So after of these 8 red balls, you need to, you are supposed to draw one ball which is equal to equal to 8C1 divided by 18C1. Similarly for white, you are having 6C1 divided by 18C1. Okay, simply for any question, you need to identify what is the sample space and what is the event. What is the corresponding event where you are calculating the probability. Now for the third one, what they are asking? Either red or white. R is nothing but simply you need to consider the union. A union B, that is nothing but P of A union B. Suppose if you consider this as the A and this are the B, then this one is equal to P of A union B. What is that one? Which is equal to P of A. Already we have seen P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Here intersection B equal to 0 only. There is no combination of the red and white. Some part is red and some part white is not available. So this value is equal to simply your 8 by 18C1 plus 61 divided by 18C1, this value is equal to 14 divided by 18 only. 40 minus 0 is equal to 14 divided by 18 only. Then what about the next one? What they are asking? Either red and white. Red or white. Okay. Then last one is the not a black ball. Okay, the ball should be not a black ball. That is nothing but it may be either red or white. It may be either red or white, the singular box only. Not a black ball is nothing but it may be either red or white only. Red or white, that is nothing but the third one only, which is equal to 14 by 18 only. Okay, not a black or red or white, both are same only. Okay, actually the question here is equal to white or black. The question, fifth question, white or black. White or black is nothing but simply which is equal to white is equal to 4 and black is equal to 6 by 18 plus 4 by 18 which is equal to 10 by 18. It's equal to 10 by 18 like this. Then next one. Simple question. Only for the to cover all the models you have to design. You have to write down and you have to solve. Number of two digits directly, immediately, whenever you listen the word digits or letters, immediately appear in your mind is that permutation or order of the appearance you have to consider. Okay, if you consider this combination only, along with combination, order of appearance to be considered whenever you listen the word digits or letters. Is there any particular order. Okay, then the number of two digits is formed with the digits 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. Number of two digits is formed with the digits 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 without repetition. We are calling without repetition. Okay, repetition bar I am considering. What is the probability that the number should be 35? What is the probability that the number should be 35? The event they have given as 35. Okay, a two-digit number is to be formed using the digits 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. What is the probability that the formed number should be 35? Okay, the formal number should be 35. That nothing but event is equal to 35. Event is your 35 only. What is the sample space? How many elements will be there in the sample space? From this n of e equal to 1 only. Now, how many elements will be there in the sample space? In the sample space, out of these 4, you need to consider 2. This is equal to 4C2 into an arrangement between the two numbers which is equal to 2 factorial. This can be represented as 4P2. This can be represented as 4P2. What is the value of this 4P2? 4 or 5 numbers are there, so 5C2. Whatever, 5 numbers are there, so 5C2. If 4 numbers are there, then 5P2. What is this 5P2? 5 8 is equal to simply 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial, which is equal to 20. Which is equal to 20. So the corresponding probability here is equal to n of e divided by n of s, n of e by n of s, which is equal to 1 divided by 20. 1 divided by 20, nothing is there. Okay, simple. To calculate the number of elements in the sample space and the number of elements in the event. Number of elements in the sample space here is equal to, out of these 5, you need to form a 2 digit number, which is equal to 5p2 or 5c2 into 2 factorial, whatever. 5 into 2 factorial is equal to 20, then the corresponding probability is equal to 1 by 20. Now, next one. Suppose 12 persons sit in a round table. 12 persons sit in a round table. Okay, 12 persons sit in a row or 12 persons sit in a round table. Already we have seen the permutations. Okay, here also the order is important. Order is important. Listen carefully. Write down. 12 persons sit in a round table. What is the probability that 12 persons sit in a round table, what is the probability that 2 particular persons, what is the probability that 2 particular persons sit together, what is the probability that 2 particular persons sit together? Okay, here the 12 persons sit in a round table and the probability that 2 particular persons, 2 persons sit together. Sit together, all you have done these questions. Okay, 12 persons in a round table. Total how many ways actually the probability for direct I'm writing. Total how many ways actually 12 persons sitting in a round table is nothing but already you have seen n persons sitting in a circle or sitting in a circle or in the round table, then the number of combinations is equal to number of permutations possible is equal to n minus 1 factorial. Already you have seen clearly. Okay, so this is equal to 12 minus 1 factorial. Two persons are sitting together means number of ways all you have calculated by treating these two as the one unit, these two as the one unit, and the total units is equal to 10 plus 1, which is equal to 11 units. Out of this 12, 12 minus 2, 10 plus these two are the one unit, which is equal to 11 units. These 11 can be arranged in how many ways? 11 minus 1 factorial into, and you have to arrange those two persons, between those two persons is equal to normal element only, which is equal to 2 factorial, so this value will become 10 factorial into 2 factorial divided by 11 factorial, whatever the answer you will get, that will be the answer, 10 factorial into 2 factorial by 11 factorial. Now, suppose, in above question, what is the probability that 2 persons not sit together, 2 persons not together, here already we have seen not together means total minus together. Not two together means total minus together. So here total minus together. So corresponding probability is equal to probability of total is nothing but simply 1 only. Because probability of total is nothing but 11 factorial divided by 11 factorial, which is equal to 1 only. So 1 minus together is nothing but 10 factorial into 2 factorial divided by 11 factorial, whatever. Okay, 11 factorial, whatever. Not together, already we have calculated. Not together means total minus together. Total minus together from this directly you can write probability is equal to probability of this total is nothing but your total sample space only. 11 factorial divided by 11 factorial, which is equal to 1. Minus 10 factorial into 2 factorial divided by 11 factorial. Next one. 4 cards are drawn at random. The probability of all 4 cards of the same suit. 4 cards are drawn at random. The probability that all 4 cards of the same suit. The probability that all 4 cards of the same suit. Here orientation is that 4 cards to be drawn. So the corresponding number of elements in the sample space equal definitely 52 C4. 4 cards are to be drawn. The corresponding elements definitely should be 52 C4. And all 4 cards of the same suit. How many suits are available you are having? 4 suits are available. Okay, 4 suits are available. What are those? Diamond, heart, spade, and club. And club. These 4 cards should be of the same suit. Maybe of the diamond, maybe of the heart, maybe of the spade, and maybe of the club. Four cards they are asking. They are not mentioning about the king, jack, queen, as king, jack, queen, as or 1, 2, 3 numbers. They are not concentrating about that. Simply, they are interesting to draw 4 cards. four cards. Those four cards should be of the same suit only. Those four cards should be of the same suit only. So this can be represented as maybe from this one 13C4, or maybe from this one 13C4 plus maybe from this one 13C4 or maybe from this one equal to 13C4. Or you can say directly this value equal to, first of all you have to select any one of the suit. In how many ways? 4C1 way. Out of the four sheets, you have to select four shoots, or have to select any one of the shoot in how many ways? 4C1 ways. After that, from that shoot, you need to draw four cards. You need to do four cards. This is equal to 13C4 divided by 52C5. Whatever, this is equal to same only. Upon 13C4 plus 13C4 equal to 4 × 13C4 only divided by 52C4. Now, next one. All four cards of same number. Very, very important this one. All four cards of same number. This is the other difference. Okay. In previous one, all four cards of the same suit they are saying. Here, the all four cards of the same number. Out of these 52 C4 combinations, you will have some combinations. The four cards are having the same number. How many combinations may be possible? You need to calculate. Same number is nothing but maybe 1, 1, 1. All four cards of this one are maybe 2, 2, 2 or 3, 3, 3. Like that, how many combinations can be possible? K, K, K. A, A, A to J, Q, K. K, K, K. How many elements can be possible like this? 13 elements. So, A as to K. 13 elements can be possible in this as it is event. Even all the four cards of the same color, all the four cards of the same number, not color. Okay, same number. How many can be possible? Which is equal to 13. Out of this 13, you need to consider one is enough. Because each element is having the four cards. So the corresponding is equal to 13C1 divided by 52C4. Out of these 52C4 combinations, 13 combinations having the four cards, those are having the same number equal to 13C1 divided by 52C4, whatever the answer. Okay, now next one. Three cards drawn at random. If you want to get a clear understanding, just think about the sample space and the event, that's it. Throughout the probability. For the sample space and event, how can I get the elements? Based on the permutations and combination. Based on the combination only, no more permutation, okay? Based on the combination, along with the order of appearance if required. That's it. Now, three cards are drawn at random. Find a probability that the cards of a king, the card should be a king, queen and jack. Three cards to be drawn. Okay. Total number of elements in the sample space definitely is equal to 52C3. Definitely should be equal to 52C3. And the card should be a king, a queen or jack. They are clearly mentioning. Okay. There should be a king. There should be a jack. Out of this, how many kings are there you are having? Four kings. So the corresponding is equal to how many ways you can get this king value, this king position, how many ways we can get 4C1. And about the spin is equal to 4C1. And about the jack is equal to 4C1. Which is equal to 4C1 × 4C1 divided by 52C3. Order of appearance is not that much of matter, because the cost drawing means by mixing king, queen, jack, red king, red queen and red jack. Okay, in first position or second position or third position resemble the same only. So the corresponding is 4C1 × 4C1 by this one. So this value equal to simply 64 divided by 52C3. Answer is not a matter. Be careful while calculating the answer also. Maybe in option directly they will give you this other option also. Okay, the importance here is that the concept. Now, the bag contains 6 red, 4 green and 4 black. 4 green and 4 black. 3 balls to be drawn. 3 balls. Our intention is that 3 balls to be drawn. 3 balls to be drawn. Okay, directly sample space is equal to 14C3. Directly sample space is equal to total balls equal to 14C3. And for the event, we have to check for the condition. 3 balls to be drawn. Probability of drawing exactly 2 red balls. Probability of drawing exactly 2 red balls. They are asking probability of drawing exactly 2 red balls. Probability of drawing exactly 2 red balls. What do you think? Exactly 2 red balls they are asking. Okay, definitely there should be a 2 red balls. Okay, that is out of these 3 balls we should have 3 red balls along with red to maybe green or red to maybe blue. Red to maybe blue. Third one may be blue. Okay, this is the corresponding events you need to calculate here. Out of these two, first of all the sample space is equal to simply 14C3 and 2 red balls they are asking. 2 red balls is nothing but in how many ways? 6C out of 2. Out of 6, you can take 6 is 0. Don't treat identical. R1, R2, I think. R1, R2, R3, R4, R6. Okay. On this, you need to select 2 red balls. That's nothing but 62 into 1 green ball. Into 1 green ball or black ball, whatever. 1 green ball or black ball, whatever. So, total equal to how much? 8C1. On this, green and black, you can consider which is equal to 8C1. So, corresponding is equal to 62 into 8C1 divided by 14C2. 14C3. We are interested to 3 balls. Right. Next one. There are n articles to be distributed among. There are small n articles. Write down like that. Small n articles to distribute among n people. Small n articles to be distributed among n people. Find the probability that a particular person getting R articles. One particular person getting R articles. Okay, the event is that directly you can write first of all the number of elements in the sample space. All you have seen distribution of 3 balls into the 5 boxes. 3 balls into 5 boxes in how many ways? 3 balls into the 5 balls. For first ball you are having the 5, for second ball you are having the 5, for third ball you are having the 5, total equal to 5 to the power 3. Similarly, for one article you are having n people. For another article you are having n people. Like that you are having, this can be represented n to the power n. Already we have seen, no problem. Okay, if you want, revise the permutation class. Okay, n to the power n. And that one particular person getting R articles. One particular person getting n R, getting R articles. That is nothing but out of n articles, you have to select one article which is equal to NCR. We have to select one article which is equal to NCR. Now people became n minus 1. So this is equal to n minus 1 whole to the power. N my articles became n minus r, which is equal to ncr into n minus 1 whole to the power n minus r by n to the power n. This power concept already we have discussed. We want both the computation concept, that's it. Okay, the total sample space is equal to, sample space is nothing but n articles to be distributed among the n people in the n to the power n ways. Our event is equal to the probability that one particular person may select R articles, may select R articles. One particular person already we have seen, one particular person always included. At that situation, 1 into n minus 1 C R minus 1 already we have seen. Like that, here also, where R articles will have to be given to the person out of these n articles in the how many ways? NCR ways, into the remaining peoples are n minus 1 and remaining articles are n minus r. Those n minus r articles to be distributed to the remaining n minus 1 people in the n minus 1 whole to the power n minus r, capital n small n, n minus r ways. Then, next one. What is the probability of getting a total of less than 12 in a throw of 2 dice in a throw of 2 days. Probability of getting a total less than 12 in a throw of 2 days. In a throw of 2 days, and again, whenever you see the word sum of some number on drawing in 2 days, form a table 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sum should be less than 12, they are saying that. Less than 12 is nothing but up to sum should be 1, minimum is equal to 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This much of combinations you have to consider up to the 11. Sum may be 2, 1, 1. Sum may be 3, 1, 2 and 2, 1. 1, 3 and 3, 1, 2, 2, like that you need to consider. Instead of considering this one, go for negative probability. Negative probability is nothing but instead of calculating the probability of less than 12, which is equal to 1 minus probability of sum is greater than or equal to 12. 1 minus sum of greater than or equal to 12. Total is sum of total less than 12 is equal to 1 minus probability of sum greater than or equal to 12. Sum greater than or equal to 12 means we are having only one element, which is equal to 6, 6. After the 6, 6, you are not allowed, because we have maximum possibility of outcome by throwing a die equal to 6 only. 6 only. So only one event. For this one, the corresponding event is equal to 6, 6. Corresponding event is equal to 6, 6. So our overall probability, this is equal to simply 1 minus 1 divided by total how many? 36. 1 divided by total how many? 36. Because 2 dice are thrown, we are getting the combination already we have seen. 6 for 1 row. So there are 6 rows. There are such type of rows. We are having the 6. 6 into 6, 36. So the corresponding probability will become this equal to 35 upon 36. This is equal to 35 upon 36, which is the probability of getting a sum less than 12. Okay. So be careful about the we have to keep your mind about the negative probability and the situation at least, and for these type of big element, big combinations, you may use the negative probability, which is equal to 1 minus sum greater than equal to 12. Okay, try this question in the reference way. As what is the probability of getting a sum? Probability of getting a sum of at least 6. Probability of getting a sum of at least 6. Sum of at least 6. At least 6 is nothing but sum should be 6, 7, 8. Sum should be either 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, up to that. And if you go on the negative probability, which is equal to, one corresponding probability is equal to one minus probability of sum is less than 6, or we can say less than or equal to 5. Okay, at least 6 is nothing but greater than or equal to 6. We can say this is equal to sum of less than 6, or sum less than or equal to 5. How many combinations may be possible with this 5? How many possibilities may be possible with this 5? Okay, here 5 means 1 comma 4, one thing, and 5. Up to 5 is nothing but 1 comma is equal to 1 minus P of sum equal to 1 comma, minimum is 2, 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5, 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. For 2, how many elements are there? 1 comma 1 for 2. And for 3, how many are there? This is for 2, 1 comma 1. And for 3, this is 1 comma 2. One possibility, and one more thing is 2, 1, one possibility. 2, 1, one possibility. And for the 4, we have 2, 2, 1, 3, and 3, 1 also possible. 3, 1 also possible. What about for 5? For 5 we have 1, 4, 4, 1, 1, 4, 2, 3, 3, 2. 3, 2. How many possibilities total we are having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 8, 9, 10. So this value is equal to simply 1 minus 10 upon 36. 1 minus 10 upon 36 in different way. Whatever. No, if you don't want to go through the negative probability, go through the normal probability also. For 6, for 7, for 8, for 9, for 10, for 11, for 12. Try to check and take it as a practice. And try to check this one. 1, 5, one possibility. 1 for the 6. And 5, 1 is one possibility. 3, 3 is one more possibility. 2, 4 is one more possibility. 4, 2 is one more possibility. Okay, everything you have to consider. Okay, if you consider 1, 3, and you have to consider 3, 1 also. Okay, don't treat this 1, 3 and 3, 1 as one element only. Okay, you have to consider both. Next one. There are 4 envelopes. There are 4 envelopes corresponding to there are four envelopes corresponding to four letters. Corresponding to four letters. If the letters are placed in envelope, if the letters are placed in envelope in random, if the letters are placed in envelope in random, what is the probability? What is the probability that all the letters are? What is the probability that all the letters are not placed in a right envelope? All the what is the probability that the letters are not placed in a right envelope? You are having four envelopes corresponding to four letters. Four envelopes corresponding to four letters. First of all, you have to calculate the sample space, number of elements in the sample space. In how many ways? For letter 1, 4 envelopes are for letter 1, 4 are available. For letter 2, 3 only available. And for letter 3, 2 available. For letter 4, for letter 1, 4 envelopes are available. For letter 2, 3 envelopes only available, 2 available and 1 available. So, the correspondingly the number of elements in the sample space equal to 4 factorial. Already we have seen. Okay, 4 factorial. And they are asking, what is the probability, what is the probability that these letters not to be placed in the right envelope, not to be placed in the right envelope. There may be only one possibility to place these letters into a right envelope. These letters into a right envelope, okay. If you want to place this letter into the right envelope, you are having only one right envelope. Only one way. For placing into the right envelope I am talking. Okay. In only one way, you can place this letter into the right envelope. This letter into the right envelope. And this letter into the right envelope. Only one way. This into the right only one way. And this into the right only in one way. Out of these four factorial ways, you are having only one way to place this envelope into the right envelope. This letter into the right envelope. So which is equal to 1 by 4 factorial, which is the probability for placing into the right envelope. And our question is that what is the probability that the letter not to be placed in the right envelope. So the corresponding probability is equal to 1 minus placing in the right envelope. 1 minus placing in the right envelope. So this is importance of the negative probability, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4 factorial, whatever the answer. 1 minus 1 by 4 factorial, whatever the answer. Now, next one. Similar question. What is the probability that in a group of 3 people, what is the probability that in a group of 3 people, how many 3 people in a group of 3 people, at least 2 will have same birthday. Okay, did not mention anything about the leap year and non-leap year. By default, you will consider which is a non-leap year. Okay, by default, non-leap year. At least 2 will have the same birthday. This is our question. The event is that the group of three people. The probability that at least 2 will have the same birthday. At least 2 will have the same birthday. 2-3 persons are there. P1, P2, P3. And that at least 2 should have the same birthday. Or at least 2 is nothing but maybe 2 persons have the same birthday. Or all the 3 persons having the same birthday. All the 3 persons are having the same birthday. This can be calculated. 1 minus no person having the same birthday. 1 minus no person is having the same birthday. Right. 1 minus no person is having the same birthday, which will give you the persons, those are at least 2 persons having the same birthday. That is equal only. Okay, for all these 3 persons having the different birthdays is nothing but no 2 are having the same birthday or no 3 are having the same birthday. So the corresponding probability is equal to P minus out of total number of how many combinations? How many combinations? Nothing but for one people, the possibilities are 365 days. For second people, the possibilities are 365 days. The third people, the possibilities are 365 days. Simply like that one only. Okay, simply like your balls placed in the boxes. Balls placed in the boxes like that only. Okay. Distribution of some articles into the persons like that only. We have to for one people the availability are 365 days. Any day they may be the birthday of that people. And for second people also availability 365 days. For third people also availability 365 days. So 365 into 365. Now listen. For first person, concentrating on the first person, the availability of 365 days. Availability of 365 days, on the 365 days, they may be one of the days the birthday. And for the second person, there should be a different date of birth. The date of birth of this one and this one should not to be coincide. So for the second person, the available days are only 364 days. The available days are only 364 days, which is equal to into 364, and for the third person, how many available are there? Only 363, because 3 days were reserved for the first two persons, and the third person should not coincide with the two persons. So the correspondingly, which is equal to 363 days, okay, 363 days. This is the case, the probability that all the three persons having the different birthday, okay, different birthday. But the question is that the probability of at least two will have the same birth rate. So we have to subtract this from the one. This is our required probability. Okay, required probability. Very important model. In different types, they may ask you. Okay, see, three persons got an accident on a week. What is the probability that at least two persons got an accident on the same day? In a week means we have to consider 7. In place of 365, you need to consider 7. In the month of August, they may give you. Okay, they may give you. In the month of something, they may give you. Okay, in different ways, they may form the question. The interest is that, the concept here is that you have to be concentrated, you have to be keep a point in your mind about the negative probability. Okay, getting or not? Right.